Yo, there are three events happening in Raid Shadow Legends this morning that you should probably take note of. The first one is an upcoming progressive chance event. Tuesday and Wednesday, it's always time to pull shards, but this one is the 15x progressive chance to get some special champions. And this one is so special, and the champions on this pool list is huge because there's no CVC. Whenever there's no CVC, they try to make it, you know, more exciting for you guys to maybe want to pull your shards. This is not for newer players. Pulling your shards in the middle of the week, in the middle of a fusion, is just irresponsible for free-to-play players. So, but if you're looking for this champion specifically, this might be your best chance of getting them. So the champions on this list is huge. The first list coming up on Tuesday, the 9th of July, will be Kandrafon, Rotos, Harima, and Ragash. These are great damage dealers in the arena. You can obtain from Ancient Shard, Primal Shards, or Sacred Shards on Tuesday if you're pulling for this 15x progressive chance event. You have one slot to put in any of these champions, or you can put in the Void Legendary Champions, White King Narsis, or Leorius the Proud. Just one slot for any of them. So that's the pool, champion pools for Tuesday. And then for Wednesday, we have another champion pool that's going to be War Master, Othroyne, Necmota, Hero, the Backhorn, Razovag, Akrisia, and Tuhanarak. I don't know what these champions have in common. Maybe somebody can let me know. But anyways, that's what the slot is for Wednesday if you're pulling shards. I know a lot of people will try to eye the Tuesday slot instead of the Wednesday slot because these are just seems like normal champions. But the Tuesday slot seems more like most wanted champions in Raid Arena at least. So that's the first event that is happening in Raid. The second one, if you get to your game right now, you see a summoning portal, not just this guaranteed ancient that is about to end for this champion. No, scroll down further, you see summoning pool event that is active. I always say these summoning pool events are trash, they are scams and all that, but we all agree that it's the best chance for you to get some amazing epic, specific epics from a limited champion pool. So that's what I try to tell people when they're coming to this event. Just aim for the epics. So if there's any epics on this list that you want so bad, especially if you're a new player to Raid, the events that you have to do for this one might be something you can achieve by farming Spider 20. Well, that's one of the events. There might be other events that are coming up that will help you get points towards obtaining that, your Prism Crystal, so you can at least have one summon pool right here and be as lucky as I was the last time I did when I got a copy of one legendary champion. I always say I've never gotten a legendary, but finally I got a legendary from this the last time, the summoning pool. And so I can't say it's scam anymore, but I still look forward to getting an epic. There is one epic that catches my attention so much in this one, and you never guess which one it is. It's not the big Ugo that is beneficial for the early game champions or players who are trying to beat the Hydra for the first time. And it's not this one who is needed in the early game for everywhere you go, for as long as Reviver is concerned. It's not your best HP bomb champion in the early game. Mordecai Wood places the HP bomb without even hitting the allies. That means he gets no, without hitting the enemy, that means he gets no weak hit. It's not this one. Doompriest, every turn should have a cleanse. Every turn she has a cleanse. The best cleanser for Doom Tower. Doompriest, Doom Tower, you see how her name even rhymes. She's been released long time in the game before even Doom Tower was put into the game. But her name still rhymes with that content. But she does that job in every content. Extremely difficult to deal with an increased attack AoE too. And then this awesome Reviver, Gogorab, will help me a lot in the early game. So you have a lot of options. Stagnite, MVP, decrease defense, decrease attack. And our MVP leader in every content in the leader slot with his 19% speed aura in any content, all battles, decking, whether it's arena or PvE. So those are all crazy epics, right? But I, on my endgame account, I'm looking forward to a Oifrig. Why? It's not because I want to build him or anything. It's because that's one champion that I need to help me complete this My Lady Mikage fusion. So if I can obtain this champion, I'll be fine with it. So I will be looking forward to getting not just one summoning of this Prism Shard. I'm looking forward to doing at least two summoning of this Prism Shard. So they have not released how we're going to get the second event yet. So far, all I see is that tournament for Spider. And if you head over to the Spider, which is the third event that is happening, I wanted to tell you about. The Spider is... well, it's still the second event. The third event is the fusion events and stuff. I'll talk about it, the fusion for last. How far I've gone on my fragment so far. The Spider is reasonable. But this one requires to farm only the spider with epics only. If you farm the spider with legendaries or reds, you will not get points towards the spider tournament. We've seen this type of event before. Before even recording this video, I put together my spider team already. That shows you how ready I am. Not for hard mode, unfortunately, but for at least spider 25. I put together a team that can do it consistently. What you need, HP burn, freeze, and just chill. Turn meter reduction, maybe. It's not essential. But HP burn, freeze for the spiderlings, and no damage. I'm not going to do enemy max HP nuke. You have your husk and your royal guard to also. That's an alternate way of taking that down the spider content. At level 20, if you can farm at level 20 with epics only, get it done and get one chance to pull in that summoning pool event. Now, take note, this will only be for those who have already skipped on the fusion, so this is something to keep you busy. But I'm going for the fusion, I can still take a break and do this. Why am I taking a break? It's because the fusion has a break for me, at least in one day. I rushed and completed everything, artifact enhancement, champion training, so today I have nothing to do regards to the fusion. I'm just gonna chill live on stream. So here's what I mean. Check out Dungeon Divers. Without Dungeon Divers active, there's no need to do the spider, there's no need to do the Fire Knight. A Fire Knight tournament is currently going on for that fusion, so I'm taking a break. Until 19 hours when this Dungeon Divers starts up, that's when I can go crazy. For the spider tournament I just showed you, to get epics only spider tournament, and the Fire Knight tournament for the fusion. So remember, the spider tournament is not part of the fusion. It doesn't give you any fragments, so take note of that. The fusion still has its own spider tournament coming up. So this might be also an opportunity for me to farm a bunch of silver that I probably don't need, but spider is best way to get silver. So it's a win-win. You're getting a prism crystal, farming epics only, and you're also getting a bunch of silver in return, because we farm the spider at hard mode 10 right now, and you're telling me to go farm the spider at 25, level 25 normal. That means 99.999% of the gear farmed from normal at the end game stage will be sold, because they are mostly 5-star or 6-star rare. You might get some game-changing epics though, so never know. Just review that when you farm the spider before you sell everything you get from that content. So now, finally, for the last piece of information that is happening in raid regarding the fusion, that's the one I wanted to say for last. I wanted to showcase my fragments, because whether you like it or not, it's still part of something that is going on in raid right now. And that's the Shike fusion. I currently have 35 fragments. I should have 40 right now, but I paused on that Fire Knight. I did not go crazy for the Fire Knight because I'm waiting till Dungeon Divers 2 resumes before I start going for the Fire Knight. So are you on track? You have to be keeping an eye out for this event. Make sure you don't miss out on anything. If I should go to my fusion calendar right now and pop it open to see if we missed out on anything on the calendar. Put it on this screen. Yes. So that's 5, 10, 15. Champion training 10, 25, 30, 35. So the only one that I've not done right here is that Fire Knight. I just did my quick count and I saw that only Fire Knight, as at Monday today, only Fire Knight is the one I'm missing 5 fragments from. So I'm on track. I missed out 10 fragments from the Summon Rush. Take note of that, because I intend to skip 10 fragments from this fusion. You can skip 10 fragments, and that's all I have for you guys today. I will be going live on twitch.tv/bricks5d to really focus on this Noob to Pro. You know, I talked about the Noob to Pro that it's back. Yes, it's back. So taking a day, an entire day of not doing anything on this main account in terms of fusion, just farming the spider tomorrow when it kicks off, farming the Fire Knight tomorrow when it kicks off. So today my account will be chilling. I've done my dailies already, so I'll just head over to the Noob to Pro and do some Noob to Pro activity on the live stream on Twitch. So make sure you join us if you can. And hopefully you guys enjoy yesterday's YouTube stream. So the entire week I'll be live daily on Twitch. Even if it's for an hour or two, it's still a daily streams on twitch.tv/bricks5d. Bring your free Amazon Prime subscription over there too and support the channel. I look forward to see you guys there. All right, let me know in the comments below if you're going for that spider epics only tournament, or you think it's something that is not worth it, because I feel like it's something that is going to be worth it no matter the level you are. Just don't try to go for the legendaries. I did not try to hype you that you're going to get a Kaima, a Duchess. You can see I only focused on the epics. I don't see the legendaries. Now, if you're one of those lucky ones and you manage to get the legendary, Ankora is an option, Kaima for sure. So I don't want to raise your hopes up. Just try to see if you can obtain any of these epics to help your account. Worst comes to the worst, you can get a plus one or plus two or plus four rector from this event. So so see it as an opportunity to get your plus one champion, to get your faction guardian, to, or to get a game-changing champion that will help your Lady Mikage fusion get complete if you don't have an oil frig already. So no matter what it goes, you get silver or you get an epic for free. All right. See you guys in the next one. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more daily raid content. Later, guys.